And they won a Thanksgiving tournament here, winning two games. They won their conference tournament in this building. And their Elite Eight win on Tuesday against East Stroudsburg. We're underway with Queens, a 32-3 team, controlling the opening tip. First appearance in the semifinals for the Royals since 2003.
You know, it's funny, all four of these teams that we're seeing in the Final Four, straight, basic, man-to-man defense.
Jalen Alexander back out to Withers. He's the All-American, trying to force a pass and a turnover.
But we're going to see a lot of pressure in the full court by this Queens team.
And Paul Sather, the Northern State head coach, said, you know, in our league, we don't see a lot of pressure. But on Tuesday night, East Stroudsburg put the pressure on. They forced 19 turnovers. But as Sather told us, he was glad they got to see that pressure because it'll help them out. It's hard to simulate as Paterka gets the bounce on the three.
Well, he's their best three-point shooter, second-team all-league player. In the Northern Sun Intercollegiate Conference, he has been really good all year.
His 73 of the year, that leads the team. And inside off glass for two, it's Louis Diankulu. He had 11 points in the Elite Eight victory over Cal Baptist. And a foul is called on Northern State. That's going to go on Gabe King as we take a closer look at Northern State. And enrollment of just over 3,600. Opened in 1901. And it's precisely 205 miles from here in Sioux Falls. Diankulu. Guarded by Carter Evans, good defense, has to put it back out.
And Northern State will play Carter Evans and Logan Doyle. They split the game at center, both very good offensive players. They don't play together hardly ever.
And a big block by Pollard.
Great pass.
Paterka cuts and he's fouled off the feed from Carter Evans.
This is great defense on the ball by Pollard. And then you see it again right there.
Fouls on Mike Davis. And the officials tonight, Kevin Chambliss, Brad Fowler, Irvin Wilson. Paul Sather in his eighth season as Northern State head coach. His alma mater. He graduated in 1996, former captain of the Wolves basketball team. And Bart Lundy now in his fifth season of his second stint as the Queens head coach, his 10th year overall as their head coach. Shot clock at 8, and it goes out of bounds. It's a turnover.
Yeah, Agusi tried to sell it that it was off Northern State, but no.
Four trips, two turnovers for the Royals, who are located in Charlotte, and enrollment just over 1,800. And the school opened in 1857, used to be an all-women's college until 1989. So the basketball program is not all that old. Or we're old, and we don't think 1989 is very old. Evans turnaround, doesn't get the bounce.
And Todd Withers was up there for that rebound.
Withers can shoot the three. His first attempt is short. And the rebound to Paterka. The lefty bounces it to Pollard. Now Ian Smith will send it back out. And Northern State will set up its offense. They shoot 51%. That's fourth best in the country. Although that shot by Pollard, not a good look.
You know, they really move well without the ball. They've had two really good cuts so far in this game, Northern State.
Davis in the paint. Bounces it. And it's picked up by Diankulu. Look at this defense by Northern State. Now a deep three for Agassi. It's good. Mike Agassi, a 37% three-point shooter. He ties the game at 5. And a whistle and a foul. And that that's going to go on Withers. He's the All-American.
But Agassi shot a deep three here. The penetration drew all the defense in, and Agassi knocks out a rainbow three. That's deep.
Transfer from Jacksonville College, now in his senior season with the Royals. And he'll get a breather on the bench. Daniel Carr has checked in. Sophomore from North Augusta, South Carolina. Nice moves by Ian Smith. With the left hand, can't finish, tipped around, and the Royals have it. Racing up ahead is Alexander. Alexander for two. Here's Ian Smith. A lob, tough catch there by Logan Doyle. Sends it back out to Smith for three. It's good.
Great ball movement that time. They got the inside out. They make about eight threes a game.
Queens has three field goals by three different players. And here's a three for Davis, way off the mark, but the offensive rebound to Carr. First shot clock for the Royals. And inside, Deion Kulu with a nice move.
Deion Kulu is a little bit of an undersized post player at 6'5", 6'6", but he's very strong and tough in there.
He had 12.7 rebounds in the Sweet 16 win over rival Lincoln Memorial, the number one ranked team in Division II. In fact, Queens has three losses this year, all three to Lincoln Memorial. But in the fourth meeting in the NCAA tournament, it was the Royals winning at Lincoln Memorial.
Well, and we know how good Lincoln Memorial's been, Andrew.
The Rail Splitters have been on a good run here in Division II, but knocked out by Queens. Northern State 0 for 3 on twos and 2 for 3 from beyond the arc so far. 10 on the shot clock. Here's Doyle. Doyle blocked. Great defense by Deion Kulu. Out of bounds to Queens. So far, the Royals have weathered this
stuff for us on every team, everything there is. We're getting emails. He's the best.
25 years. Congratulations, Roy. It's been a heck of a run. And we thank you from the bottom of our heart. 14:20 to go, first half. And Queens continues to impress inside. They have 8 points in the paint.
Well, right now, Deion Kulu's athleticism is really giving the bigs from Northern State a problem.
And a foul. Called on Queens. That'll be on Sean Willett.
I mean, they're going to have to figure out what to do with Deion Kulu. He's 3 for 3 from the field, and he's getting layups.
Carter Evans returns as Logan Doyle goes to the bench. And Steve mentioned it, but Paul Sather said very rare that they'll play the two of those guys, their centers, together. Northern State has just one field goal in the last 5.5 minutes. Here's Willett. Trying to split the D, puts up a shot, and it rattles in.
And in the tape that I've watched about this team, Andrew, this Willett is like an instant offense.
His first season at Queens, the transfer from Indian River State. Both threes. Nearly a turnover, but Paterka saves it. Paterka, baseline, and he can't finish. Northern State is now 0 for 5 on layups here in the first half.
I think the athleticism, this kid is tough.
Yeah, Willett for two, and Paul Sather calls timeout. What a job by the Royals. Queens, a 15-8 advantage, and Bart Lundy told us that he wasn't worried about his team in this environment. He said we played in a lot of tough road games all season. I think our guys will be ready and early on. He's not kidding. This Queens is up by 7. How about this, though? Northern State 0 for 6 on layups. Queens is 6 for 6 on layups.
They're very athletic. They finish, and they're quick. And you can see they really have Northern out of their comfort zone.
King hits a three.
And I saw in the tape, Carter Evans does a great job of always throwing the ball to the opposite side of the court. A really good passer for a big guy.
Paul Sather is hot at an official. He's got to be careful. Looked like the official was getting ready to tee him up. Van Zier wanted to travel. Iancoulou turn around. Not this time. And Evans the rebound. Dean Smith, such a great ball handler, but that shot is way off the mark. Smith, first team all-conference in the Northern Sun. Oh, and a sloppy turnover as Agassi dribbled it off his foot. And a timeout. 11:58 to go. Bart Lundy in the open three.
And one they needed.
Three assists on three made field goals for the Wolves. And so far, even though the Royals have the lead, Withers is scoreless. Turnover, though, by Northern State. That's their second here in the first half.
Even though they're only down four, they seem a little uncomfortable. I think the athleticism and the quickness of Queens is bothering them. That last play from the low post and three obviously helped, but not comfortable right now and getting driven on a lot.
Carr, jumper. Northern State has won a school record 35 games this year. Step back three, and King this time with an air ball.
Another good pass from Carter Evans to the weak side of the floor.
And Logan Doyle will come back in. Carter Evans goes out. That's the 1-2 monster at center for the Wolves.
One of those guys will be in the game at all the time, at all times, but never be in together.
I just thought that defensively is something they couldn't compensate for with both of those big men in.
Especially against a team with this quickness.
Sure. Out of bounds, it'll be Northern State basketball. There you see Bart Lundy. His 15th year as a head coach at the D1 or D2 level. He was the head coach at Division I High Point for 6 years. Northern State still without a two-point field goal. They're 0-for-7. That's a three, and it won't go. Willett up ahead. Alexander finishes.
They get out on that break so fast.
Points in the paint, 14-0 in favor of Queens. And now it's 14-2. As Doyle with the throwdown, and he's fouled. First foul on Jalen Alexander.
Well, Logan Doyle does a great job of sealing up there and has delivered a nice pass on the move. So he's able to elevate and dunk it.
First two-point field goal of the night for Northern State. And they trail by three. As we move closer to the midway point of the first half, the D2 semifinals. Winner moves on to the championship game Saturday against Ferris State. Carr, short on the shot. Each team with only one offensive rebound. They throw it into Doyle, draws the double, gets it back, finds a cunning teammate, counted and won. It's Bo Freeze who will go to the line.
Well, you take a look here, their big guys are really good passers. He knows he's being doubled, and instead of standing still, Freeze cuts hard to the basket and ends up making that.
Bo knows cuts. The junior from Lankford, South Dakota. And he can't finish off the three-point play.
I've seen a lot of good cuts from these Northern State kids and a lot of good passes from their big guys. Defense!
Alexander, and will stay with the Royals. Shot clock at 10.
Pretty good defense by Peterka there.
Peterka, the senior from Miller, South Dakota, went to Miller High School. Alexander in the paint, and he banks it in. Queens shooting 9 of 16, 56% from the field. And two more points in the paint. Alexander now 3 for 3. Doyle guarded by Diancoulou. Back out to Smith for 3. Here's Withers.
Whoa.
And that 3 won't go. Withers is still scoreless so far in this game. He averages a team high 14 points per game. Paterka's 3 way off the mark. He follows his shot, but Withers has it.
Good defense by Ian Smith stopping Agassi.
Agassi over Smith, then he hits. The two number zeros matched up on that last play. Freeze had it taken away. Diancoulou hands off to Davis. Now a transition 3 for Alexander, no good. And the rebound out of bounds to Queens.
Yeah, that's a good call. That's Queens' ball.
Agassi, same spot as last time, and this time it's an air ball. A 5-point Royals lead.
Queens does a great job of getting back in transition, not giving anything easy.
Wolves have slowed down from beyond the arc. Started 3 for 4.
That was a pop.
0 for 4. Doyle, quick defense. Oh, and last touch by Doyle. Wait. Now they're saying it'll be Wolves basketball. They changed the call. For more, let's check in with Jamie Erdahl.
Well, Andrew, you mentioned the team went to the Crooked Pipe. Coach actually told us he's kind of a superstitious guy. So, of course, he went back to the bar to make sure that everyone got to cheer on the team. But we did see them at dinner last night as our crew went to dinner. So
yes.
I saw the Northern State team, and I figured if they win this one, we might all have to go back to dinner tomorrow.
And there's an injured player behind the play for Northern State. It is DJ Pollard, the senior out of St. Louis Park, Minnesota. As we take another look at what happened to Pollard.
Yeah, he hit the ground hard on this play here, Andrew. You'll see him come down really hard.
Yeah. Second team all-conference player.
This team presses about 25% of the time, which is a lot. You don't see people usually press that, but here's the run and jump when you turn your back.
Peterka stopped in a bad place, nearly turned it over.
Not only stopped in a bad place, turned his back on top of it to end up scoring.
And Ian Smith with 2.
The pass he completed, he was very lucky. But when you throw out of a trap, usually you can get something good because you're outnumbering the defense.
Davis 3, and that's just the second field goal for the Royals that has not come in the paint.
And he's a really good shooter.
26-18, inside 7 minutes to go in the first half.
That was Davis' 86-3, best three-point shooter on the team. This team is tough defensively, I'll tell you.
Here's Evans with the shot clock at 6. Evans, good move.
See, Mike Davis came to double team. He didn't come, he did come. He kind of was in no man's land, and he let Carter Evans just go.
And a good sign with Pollard back at the scorer's table, set to check in. He was the Wolf that got injured last time down. Davis, another 3. Back-to-back triples from Mike Davis, the senior out of Brunswick, Georgia. Each team with three threes in the first half. Peterka had his pass stolen by Deion Kulu. And Davis is blocked and a foul is called inside. Well, let's go back to Northern State.
Well, take a look at Mike Davis. He's going to come down now. We can roll it from there. And when he comes down, he stands in what I call no man's land. Right there. He stands in no man's land. He's not doubling, and he's not guarding his man. And he's leaving a big gap there for Carter Evans to just go around his man and go to the basket.
Davis now at the free throw line. He spent 2 years at Division II Francis Marion before transferring to Queens. Queens has scored on four consecutive trips, and this is their largest lead. It's up to 10.
I mean, you think about this, they have a 10-point lead, and the best player hasn't scored. Todd Withers.
And Paul Sather said, we just don't see teams like Queens very often in our league.
This team is really quick, very well coached, especially on the defensive end. That was a terrific run and jump. And you know what they do? They try to force you, and once you cross half court, they want to spin you and then come and get you from the weak side. That's what's called a run and jump defense. Very effective in this game so far.
Six turnover of the half. Meanwhile, for the Royals, Davis has scored all of their last 8 points. He's got the ball right here. Back out Agassi for three. And the rebound to Ian Smith. Wolves need some offense. Smith had it taken away. Great play by Agassi, but he gives it right back. It nearly went in. Out of it something.
Sather wants a foul.
This is Andrew Coleman who's checked into the game, the freshman out of Chaska, Minnesota. Northern State has three consecutive turnovers. Shot clock at 10. Evans. And another turnover. Make it four in a row for the Wolves. And this crowd, which is filled up with Wolves shirts, is very quiet right now. The Royals are up 11.
Well, I'll tell you what, this is a very aggressive defensive team.
Turnover by Queens. And the other way. A charge is called on DJ Pollard. Five straight turnovers now for Northern State.
I really thought that was terrific defense. That's a charge. He got there. He was still. That is good defense. I'm telling you what, Andrew, this is a very, very well-schooled defensive team. They know when to come after you, when to trap. They turn you at the half-court line. They know exactly what they want to do.
Five consecutive turnovers, eight and a half for the Wolves. Alexander, good defense and shot. And now Smith the other way. And another turnover, six in a row for Northern State. And a timeout.
Side, and good things happen. Very well schooled defensively, this team in that press.
What'd you hear during that timeout, Jamie?
Well, Paul Sather thankful for the timeout. He told his team, we're getting way too sped up. They're allowing us to speed up in our offense. He pleaded with them to go deeper into the shot clock, saying Queens doesn't want to guard us for 30 seconds totally. Also, post touches and switching on this ball screen that you're going to see up here for Queens, important for Northern State.
I think that's a great point by Coach Sather in terms of trying to get control of this offense in the half court and slow this thing up. The problem is this team is so fast. It's easier said than he knows that too. He's got to say that to his kids because that's what he wants them to do, but it's not that easy.
Solomon Smith fouled after that big offensive rebound. How about this? I mean, Queens is up 11. Their best player, Withers, hasn't scored, and they've only converted for 2 points off the 9 turnovers by Northern State.
That's unbelievable.
Agassi for three. Let's see where the Wolves go for offense. Paterka and a foul inside. That's going to go on Solomon Smith, the freshman.
Well, that's what Paul Sather said. Get the ball inside. Get our big guys touches. The truth is, their best half-court offense in terms of passing, getting easier shots, is when the big guys touch the ball.
Six team fouls on Queens, so Northern State will shoot the rest of the half. Nice dish to Doyle, to Pollard, but he couldn't get a handle on it. Another turnover, and the other way, a tie-up. Good defense. As Carl was tied up, the possession arrow favors Northern State.
One thing that you're seeing with Queens is they're like everywhere. This is good defense by Paterka.
But on the other end, that was the 7th straight turnover.
Quick
7 game. Straight possessions, they've turned it over.
Which is ridiculous, obviously, especially for a great team that this Northern State team is. But this team is really fast.
Wolves without a field goal in just under 4 minutes now.
And they keep the heat on everywhere. You don't get an easy pass.
And a foul inside. It's going to go on Solomon Smith again as he was tangled up with Logan Doyle. And that will send the Wolves to the line for a 1-1. Logan Doyle, Alexandria, Minnesota native, transfer from South Dakota State, second team all-conference this year in the Northern Sun. And he makes the front end. Now you can get 24/7 scores, breaking news, and up-to-the-minute highlights streaming across devices, live and free on the new CBS Sports HQ. And here comes the crowd. Ten on the shot clock, get a steal. Bad pass there by Alexander. Smith all the way, and he's fouled.
Yeah, that was a horrendous pass by Alexander there. I don't know where, who this was to. He thought Withers was going to pop out, I guess.
And then on the other end, Alexander committed the foul, his second. Number 0, Ian Smith. 2 shots for Smith, a 70% free throw shooter. Smith, first team all conference this year. And he was the MVP of the Central Region Tournament. 1 out of 2 at the line. Fans are on their feet. What an atmosphere here in Sioux Falls. And backcourt. Called on Queens. And now the Royals have turned it over 3 consecutive times.
Northern State picked it up on the defensive end the last couple of minutes.
Chance of NSU for Northern State. Doyle in the paint, and a foul committed by Mike Davis. Northern State will go right back to the free throw line. They are chipping away at this lead.
Yeah, I don't think Deangulo could play behind Logan Doyle like that. He's going to get fouled. You got to get in front of him. You're quicker. Deion Kulu's much quicker. You should be able to get in front and not let him, Logan Doyle, bury him under the basket.
Second foul on Mike Davis. And Doyle makes them both. Lead is down to six. And at one point it was 11. Northern has scored five straight points, all on free throws.
They need to stop. If they can get into halftime down four, they did something really good.
That would have been travel. That's what Paul Sather wanted.
Yeah, you can't jump stop and pivot.
Deion Kulu tied up inside. And a foul is called on Northern State. And a technical's been called on Logan Doyle. Second foul on Doyle. And Agassi, an 87% free throw shooter, will shoot the technicals.
And then they get the ball again. This could end up being a huge swing.
Doyle comes out. Evans returns with 109 on the clock.
You know, it's all right to be emotional, but you can't hurt your team. And that's what Logan Doyle just did there. That was not smart at all. You're coming back. You got to take it easy.
Queens just scored their first points in 4.5 minutes.
They couldn't do anything.
Davis. His pass taken away by Paterka.
Their defense has really picked it up big time in the half court.
Final minute of the first half.
Well, there's got to be something there.
Paterka into the corner it goes. Pollard drives, reverse lay and blocked. On the putback, Evans is fouled. And Carter Evans will go to the line.
Daniel Carr was very lucky. He didn't call for a foul there. His
first personal 10-team foul. First foul on Deion Kulu. And Evans, not their best free throw shooter, which is 56%. How about this half? We've seen 20 field goals. 33-26 in favor of Queens, D2 semis. Neither team has a field goal in the last 5 minutes and 36 seconds. It's been all defense and free throws. And turnovers.
Some of those too, yeah.
12-second difference between the game clock and the shot clock here. Davis, quick shot.
Tough shot.
And Sather is saying, let's get the last shot.
Oh, yeah, they got to run this thing down as far as they can. Like I said, if they come into the, if they go into halftime down four, they'll have won the half.
Such a strange half. Withers hasn't scored. The turnovers go over, and somehow it's a two-possession game.
Plenty of time. Oh, he's going to shoot too soon.
And Smith gets it to go. Four-point game. 5 seconds left. Agassi at midcourt. Agassi driving. And that'll do it for the first half. Northern State closes the half on a...
Well, there's no doubt that they got sped up. And it wasn't, I don't think it was their doing. I think they got sped up by Queens. They, at the end of the half, started gaining a little bit of control again. Let's see if they can keep it going at the start of the second half.
Queens scored 100 points on Tuesday. They had 17 assists. First half, 33 points and just 4 assists. Winner advances to the D2 National Championship game on Saturday, 3 Eastern on CBS. Withers, 3, and he is still scoreless.
I mean, you have to think at some point, if they're going to win this game, Todd Withers has to get it going.
Evans, guarded by Deion Kulu. He goes down, and 2 for the Wolves.
Coach Sather went into that locker room and talked about getting his guys post touches. First play of the first second half, inside to Carter Evans.
And Alexander trying to quiet the crowd. The largest deficit Northern State has overcome this year to win a game is 9 points. Happened twice New Year's Eve against Minnesota State and January 13th against Augustana. Tonight, down as many as 11, trying to come back and win. Paterka, deep three is good.
Wow. I don't even think he made a clean catch, and he shot that and made it.
He's in double figures with 10 points. It's a one-point game.
He's starting that game tough around the basket, and boy, that was a heck of a strong move. Carter Evans was left flat-footed.
That quieted the crowd as the lead goes back up to three. 2 minutes into the second half. Evans, cross-court pass, Paterka, another three! And we are tied at 37.
How many times have we seen that pass from Carter Evans tonight across the court for a three?
Paterka has all 8 of Northern State's points this half. Deion Kulu with the shot clock at 4. Tried to squeeze a pass to Davis out of bounds to Queens, but only 1 on the shot clock. Agassi will inbound. They need a quick shot. Deion Kulu.
Oh, how does he not know?
How did he not know?
That's a shot clock violation. How does he not know?
In front of their bench. I mean, let's understand. He's in front of their bench, Andrew, and he didn't know there was 1 second. That was a whip pass from Carter Evans to Paterka right on the numbers so that he'd be ready to shoot it. But, I mean, 1 second on the shot clock. You're taking it out in front of your bench. And he doesn't know. Ow. That's hard.
Northern State has a chance to take the lead. And a foul on Mike Davis. Third foul. The senior Davis, and he's going to come out of the game as Daniel Carr returns.
Yeah, he's got to go out. Got to go out for 5 minutes for sure.
And we've played nearly 23 minutes now, and still no points for Todd Withers. Paterka from downtown, not this time. And the loose ball rebound scooped up by Pollard. Pollard for three. Offensive rebound to Gabe King.
Wow, that looked like a push in the back.
And a foul. As Doyle went to the ground. That is going to be on Jalen Alexander, his third.
I mean, they have good depth, but these are their better players that are getting into foul trouble now.
Layup. Oh, my goodness. A breakdown. And the Wolves have the lead thanks to DJ Pollard. First lead since it was 8-7. And the first bucket of the night for Pollard. Agassi trying to answer, and he's fouled on the drive. That'll go on Ian Smith.
Now, Northern State is making any pass they want in the half-court offense. They're not being bothered by the Queens pressure at all. This pressure has lost a little of its zip from the first half.
Shooting foul, so Agassi goes to the line.
Entering the game for Northern State, number 15.
Bo Freeze back in, and Gabe King gets a nice hand. He goes out. Agassi, a senior from Dallas, makes them both. And here's the pressure.
Didn't really run and jump on that one.
Freeze's pass deflected out by Withers. It'll stay with Northern State. Wolves have won 14 games in a row.
Number
Pollard with the shot clock at 7. Pollard to Doyle. And he travels. No. A foul was called first. And the foul's on Withers. That's his second.
Now that's traveling.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Coach Lundy has a lot to be upset about on that one.
Wolves get away with one there.
Oh, he's got it sealed up completely. Good pass.
Wide open freeze. Book it.
Those double teams are coming from the wrong guy. That time he left a guy open that was right in his vision. You got to bring it from somewhere else.
Northern State is 5 for 7 from the field this half. And this crowd is as loud as you can be. Agassiz is fouled with the shot clock at 4. And that takes us to a timeout, but Northern State since then. A 22-8 run for Northern State. And they lead it by 3 with Agassiz at the line. Queens hasn't missed a free throw yet. They're 7 for 7. Agassiz 5 for 5. And I didn't jinx him. How come you only bring it up when I do jinx that? You never give me credit when I don't.
I should have given it to you that time.
Nearly a turnover there by Pollard. He brings it back out. 5 minutes into the second half of the D2 semifinals. Freeze wants 3 more.
I'm telling you, Andrew, this pressure has not been the same for Queens. The last 4 minutes of the first half. Oh, a nice pass.
What a feed, but Willett couldn't get it to go. He gets it back and lays it in.
He's relentless, that kid.
Northern State has 4 threes this half. Freeze all the way, and he's fouled. Bo Freeze having a night.
Well, take a look at what happens when this dribble penetration comes into the lane, and then you see what happens out here. The dribble penetration creates the opening on the wing, and they knock it out.
Willett picks up his 3rd, and his teammates Davis and Alexander also a 3. So a bit of foul trouble here for the Royals. Freeze misses both. Oh, and a nice take, but Carr doesn't get it to drop. Wolves ball, they lead by 2.
I think they want to get the big guy a touch here.
Smith. Here's the touch for Doyle. Had it taken away. Great play by Carr, but he was out of bounds. Substitution for the Wolves. Paterka and Evans back in.
Oh, yeah. Clearly out of bounds.
Northern State had 11 turnovers in the first half. None here in the second. Playing much better basketball. Paterka.
You know they are. They're playing much better, Andrew, but I don't think this Queens defense is as relentless as it was in the first half.
3 ball, Willett. Great takeaway by Carr.
You know what happens sometimes? They had it going for a while, and then this is a game of momentum basketball. They lost their momentum, and they just have lost that edge in terms of their defense.
Still only down by 2. Paterka, wow, he has taken over this game. Darren Paterka, the senior from Miller, South Dakota. He's got 17. And Queens calls timeout.
Ethan Cooper's in. Coming out of their next defensive possession, look for the big man on the ball in terms of getting their offense going. They're trying to get points in the paint, according to Bart Lundy.
Yeah, I think he's
right? They got to get that press going because that press was very disruptive in the first half.
And a foul on the floor called on Northern State. That'll go on Paterka. That's his third.
You know, it's interesting, Andrew. It doesn't take much to lose the edge. They had that edge in the first half, the first 15 minutes of the game. They have lost that step, that edge. Whether they've lost some confidence because of the way they've been attacked, I don't know, but they're just not the same.
How about the crowd and the role they've played in this run?
They've helped, though. There's no question. They've given this team confidence.
Willett, man, he's picking up the Royals right now.
You know, Carter Evans can't stay with any of these guys off the dribble. They're all tough for him. Even though he's undersized, look how much smaller Willett is than Carter Evans. But he's going to go by him every time.
And how about this? A two-point game in the second half. And Todd Withers, the All-American, he's on the bench. Hasn't scored. And Bart Lundy's giving him a breather.
All-American. That's hard to imagine. Great pass.
And a foul. As Evans went up with it.
Take a look at 54 Carter Evans moving without the ball. It was a pick and dive. He dove hard after he screened for the ball, and he beat his man down to the block.
But not a shooting foul. They call it on the floor.
Wow.
And that's number four on Willett, so he comes out of the game. And he's been playing well.
He's been tough. He's a tough cover for these Northern State big guys.
Bad pass. Agassi up to Carr. And Carr had it blocked. Great play by Pollard. Pollard now gets it back. Smith finds the open space. Ian Smith. Davis playing with three fouls.
I really think Queen should get it inside. I think Deion Kuru has been able to score at will.
There you go. And the foul for Deion Kuru.
I think they got to take Carter Evans out of the game because Carter Evans is having trouble guarding any of these undersized inside guys off the dribble. It was Willett. Now it's Carter. Now it's Deion Kuru.
First foul on Carter Evans, and Deion Kuru has a chance for a three-point play.
I think he's a problem defensively right now, Carter Evans.
He had 11 points in the Elite Eight victory against Cal Biff Baptist on Tuesday, and Deion Kuru with 11 tonight. And still 12 minutes to go. Queens now 9 of 9 from the free throw line this evening.
Oh, he can't get up.
A travel. He couldn't get up. Travel on Gabe King. Winner advances to the national championship game on Saturday. 3 Eastern on CBS against the top seed Ferris State. Earlier tonight, the Bulldogs beat West Texas A&M. Davis triple. Halfway down and out, and Evans the rebound. Ian Smith is looking for Evans. A lot of contact down low. Now Smith, jumper, won't go. Oh, what a rebound and putback for Carter Evans.
And Todd Withers blocked that shot and it went in the basket.
Each team with 5 offensive rebounds. That was a big one for Evans.
I'm trying to figure out how they get Todd Withers into this game, to be honest with you.
Out of bounds. Agassi stepped out. How about the play by the senior Carter Evans on the other end?
Yeah, and it was blocked. You'll see it's blocked by Withers. He goes up with it. He gets a little piece of it. Still goes in the basket. But, you know, they got to get Withers going. Some run him off a screen. Get him to do something. Take something to the basket. He's been very, very passive this entire game.
Had 26 points on Tuesday night, yet to score tonight.
Not only yet to score, he's only taken 3 shots. I mean, I'd rather see him go 1-for-10 than do this.
Paterka, back out Smith. Good fake.
I love the fake.
Misses the three, but a long rebound chased down by King.
How simple or wide open.
Pollard, and this is the largest lead for Northern State.
And you know, this crowd is gonna, it's been fueling these guys this whole game.
5 threes this half for the Wolves. Wide open corner three, Carr. Yes, big answer from the sophomore, Carr.
That was a big answer. They got to find a way to get 33 going. I'm sorry.
That jumper won't go for Pollard, and the rebound to Agassi. Carr again. Not this time.
Not a great shot.
Davis tracks it down. Good hustle by Mike Davis. Fresh shot clock for the Royals. Past the midway point of the second half. Agassi, deep three.
Yes! And we are tied at 56.
That was a deep, tough, contested three.
Fourth tie. We've also had four lead changes tonight. King jumper. It's good.
One thing we're seeing from Northern State, much more patient, taking their time, reversing the ball, and not being as frantic. Coach Saban said, slow down. They have slowed down in their half-court offense.
Wolves on fire this half, 70% from the field. Deion Kulu in the paint. Turnaround is short. A foul is called, and Paul Sather is furious on the Northern State sideline.
That's a nice kick to the perimeter. That's a tough contested three. And then Northern off the drive and kick. A nice shot fakes. Withers leaves his feet on a bad closeout. And they knock out another one.
Fouls on Evans. That's his second. Two shots for Deion Kulu. That's the first miss at the line tonight for the Royals. They had started 9 for 9.
And it took Todd Withers out again. I mean, he looks like there's something wrong with him. Just not, he's not engaged at all, not playing hard.
And Jamie Erdahl specifically asked about Withers at halftime with Bart Lundy, and he didn't seem concerned. He said he's had big halves before. We expect he'll get going. Well, that hasn't been the case.
I got to be honest with you. He looks like very indifferent. I have to tell you what I see. Just not in it at all.
And a foul on Agassi. First foul on Ike.
You know, you're Todd Withers. You know what I tell him if I'm the coach? Go to the offensive glass. You know, I mean, take one to the basket. Get out and train to something. Block a shot. Get in the game. Or take him out.
Well, continues to sit. Agassi sits now as Darryl White checks in. He's got a big knee brace on his left knee. Has an MCL injury that caused him to miss 11 games. Thought he was out for the year, but just returned for the postseason. A senior trying to gut it out, but can't play many minutes. That's why you haven't heard his name called tonight.
They haven't run and jumped much this half. They ran the run and jump that time. They sped him up, and they turned it over. They need to get back to that run and jump press that they use a lot more in the first half.
Fans on their feet here at the Pentagon. And they're going to be sitting down after that bucket by Alexander puts the Royals back in front.
Let's see if they do the run and jump again. Yep, here it comes.
10 points for Jalen Alexander.
Another turnover.
Exactly right, Steve. Possession arrow, though, favors Northern State.
Now they've been a little helter-skelter again.
Now here's the weird stat. Northern State has turned it over 14 times. And the Royals have only scored 4 points off turnovers.
That is not taking advantage of the other team's mistakes. But now they're coming out and trapping much more aggressively, which I like. Another turnover.
And a steal. And they give it right back. White turned it over after he created the turnover. Paterka gives it right back to Davis. Up ahead, Alexander lays it in.
It's so evident that when they run this aggressive trap, that they speed up Northern State, and Northern State does not like it. Here comes the run and jump again.
They actually scored off the turnover.
They got to get a touch to the big guy.
Smith. Paterka three. Tied again.
Why are they leaving him alone? Can somebody tell me?
7 minutes to go. Paterka has 15 of his 20 here in the second half. Nearly had a steal right there. Davis brings it back out. Shot clock at 10. Davis in the corner. Wide open. Alexander.
Ooh. Oh.
Somehow that didn't go in. Smith. Nice move. Doesn't get it to go. Doyle the offensive rebound. And he's fouled on the putback. But how about the last time down the floor, Paterka again?
Well, look at this communication here. This bad communication. They don't even know who they have. Two guys have one. They are really all over the place, and they leave the wrong guy alone by himself. You can't be any more open than that. You got to talk out that transition defense and that half transition defense.
Withers is coming back in. 6:19 to go. The All-American averages 14 points per game. He's 0-3 and scoreless so far tonight. And for more on Withers, let's go over to Jamie Erlow.
Andrew, I watched him during that last time out. Several assistant coaches came over and had a conversation with him before he checked back into this game. I confirmed with the team he's not dealing with an injury, so that's not his issue up until this point.
He's only taken one shot this half.
Yeah, I mean, this is kind of jogging around out there. I don't get it.
Alexander.
I mean, you're playing for a chance to go to the national championship game.
Sixth tie of the night. Evans at the scorer's table set to check in for Northern State. It just goes silent in here when the Wolves are on offense. Paterka another three. And a rebound to Deion Kulu. Deion Kulu's been a real presence in this game.
Magazine.
Takes the screen from Deion Kulu. Agassiz spread around Doyle. Missed it. Deion Kulu, the put back, and he's fouled. And again, making his presence felt.
Evans has trouble in helping on that pick and roll, and then he couldn't get back in time. I should say, Logan Doyle.
And that's a big foul. It goes on Paterka. That's his fourth.
Take him out for a minute, maybe.
Freeze and Evans back in. Paterka and Doyle go out. But you were saying, let's find a way to get Withers involved. They didn't even touch it on that last possession.
They didn't even touch it. And the thing is, I'm watching him, and he's just kind of walking around out there. He's not even running. I don't get it.
Deion Kulu, one out of two. Queens back in front. 64-63 as we approach 5 minutes to go. Evans driving.
Oh, what a block by Deion Kulu. He's everywhere.
He's tough.
Understates throwing the ball because they have not been able to guard him off the dribble.
Deion Kulu again. Turnaround. Yes.
these big guys have, you know, they're in a tough spot in Oregon State because these big guys are helped them on offense, but defensively they have struggled all game.
And a foul called on Withers. Third foul on Withers.
Deion Kulu undersized, but that is a big time block. And then he runs the floor hard. And they have not been able to deal with him in the low post at all.
Smith makes the front end of the 1-1. Both teams in the bonus with 4:35 to play.
You know, Paul Sabin's got a tough decision here because defensively they are just attacking these big guys. You need them on one end, and then on the other end, they're killing you.
Here come the fans. What a scene here in Sioux Falls.
Well, you know they got to go inside. I mean, clear it out and let them start going off the dribble.
Agassi straightaway three. Rebound, Withers, and he's fouled on the putback. Well, there he is.
He showed something there. I mean, he was way up for that rebound, no doubt about it.
Third foul on Evans.
Nobody boxes him out, and he's up in a place that nobody can get to. That's his and only his. Nobody else getting up where he was.
He's a 76% free throw shooter, trying to get in the scoring column. And Paterka coming back in with four fouls and 4:07 on the clock. You like it?
I like it. They're going to be on offense now. I said 4 minutes.
And finally, with 4:07 to go, Withers has his first point of the game.
You know, if you're going to have these big guys in the game, Logan Doyle, you got to throw the ball.
2-on-1 after they break the press, and King counted and won.
Well, this is how you attack pressure. You throw the ball up the floor, right in the middle. That is the exact place to get it. And a good job in finishing in transition. That was a good press break by Northern State.
And Keith King puts the Wolves up by one. What a game in the semis here in Sioux Falls. Eighth lead change tonight. Alexander cuts. Back out Agassi with seven to shoot. Agassi in the paint. Agassi finishes inside.
They've had trouble all game keeping Agassi out of the lane. He's very quick and strong.
3.5 to go. 16 points for Ike Agassi. Well above his season average of 11 per game. Next whistle is a media timeout. Oh, nearly a travel. Smith got away with it. Doyle trying to tip it up and in. Comes back to Smith. Withers rips it away. Big rebound for Withers.
Ian Smith there. Not a good decision.
Queens by one.
I'll tell you, these kids need that media timeout.
Davis, and that's a shot clock violation. Did he get it off? That should not count.
That should not count.
That should not count.
They counted it.
Wow. A huge break for the Royals. That should have been a shot clock violation.
You can look at a shot clock on a made basket.
And Northern State calls timeout. 2:20. We just saw the replay. Looked like a shot clock violation.
That ball was in his hands.
So the Wolves with the ball, they trail by three with 2:15 to go. And a foul inside on Diankulu. That'll send the Wolves to the free throw line. Foul number three on Louis Diankulu. It'll be Logan Doyle at the line for two shots. That was the 10th team foul. Northern State 15 of 20 at the free throw line. Doyle, one out of two. 2-point game as we approach 2 minutes to go.
Well, Ian Smith's got to work here on keeping Agassi out of the lane.
Davis. Back out Agassi. Shot clock's at six. Agassi calls for a screen. Agassi drives. Blocked by Doyle. Oh, they called a foul.
Oh, my goodness. With the shot clock at two.
Wow. That's the third foul on Doyle. Here's another look.
No way.
Oh my gosh. Wow, they showed it on the scoreboard here.
There have been a couple of calls here at the end of the game.
Well, credit to Doyle that time. We saw him get a technical in the first half. He could have lost it there, and he didn't. He held his emotions in check. One out of two at the line. It's a three-point game.
He'd be insane to get a technical foul there. Let me just say this.
At least he didn't.
They got to get Doyle a touch.
Uh-oh. Smith lost it. Carr the other way. Carr for two. And a two-possession game with 1:15 to go.
Plenty of time, but you got to get your poise back.
A 13-6 run for Queens. And a foul.
That is a bad foul.
Not a good one there by Daniel Carr. Bart Lundy knows it. Second foul on Carr. Two shots for the Wolves.
I mean, I don't know what Ian Smith wanted. I mean, that's looked clean to me.
And Paterka couldn't really contest that shot. He's got the four fouls. Smith at the line. Sean Willett comes in. Diankulu goes out. And Carr exits with Alexander returning. Willett comes back in with four fouls. Smith makes them both.
They just need solid defense here. They do not want a foul. They just got to play solid and get a rebound. And if you're Queens, work the clock down. And I would try to get Willett.
Alexander blocked by Doyle. Seconds to go. Each team with two timeouts remaining. Smith. What? Great feed. Doyle on the finish. And Northern State calls timeout with 36 seconds to go. Withers will inbound.
Let's see how Paul Sather plays this. He's not fouling.
Wow. This is gutsy.
Very gutsy. I think you got to drag this timeout. I would not do this. You're one offensive rebound away from losing. But if you're Queens, you're shooting too soon.
Oh, blocked by Doyle! And a foul! Oh, a foul! That'll send Doyle to the free throw line!
Shot it way too soon. And by the way, it's the same block Doyle made just a few seconds ago. They called the foul. Exact same thing. Agassi goes in there way too early. You had to let this thing run all the way down. You were up one.
Doyle ties it at 74.
And Bartlett, all guys that are quick.
This to give the Wolves the lead. Missed it. Rebound Withers.
You got to run to the last shot of the game.
They get it to Agassi. 5 seconds to go. Agassi over to Withers for the game. No! And we're going to overtime.
And here we go.
Paterka has 4 fouls. And Willett has 4 fouls for Queens. Something to keep in mind here in overtime as the Wolves control the tip. And the foul, DJ Pollard.
Now, I'm going to tell you, that was terrible defense by Queens. A poor recovery and a poor closeout.
And that's the 4th foul on Withers. Pollard misses the free throw. Here's Withers. Alexander is fouled. Jalen Alexander draws the whistle with 4:29 to go in OT. And that's number 2 on Ian Smith.
These guards have had a lot of opportunity to drive the ball. But I tell you, they got Deion Kulu back in the game. I would look to get him the ball.
I was just about to say, in the last 3-4 minutes, they kind of went away from
Deion Kulu. A lot of it, it wasn't in. They went, they went with the smaller team.
Queens started 9 of 9 from the line. Since then, 4 for 8. And they miss another.
And that was a bad miss.
One out of two for Alexander. He's out. Daniel Carr back in. Here's a look at the foul trouble. Paterka with 4, Doyle has 3 for the Wolves. For Queens, Willett and Withers with 4 apiece.
I would bring that run and jump press.
Doyle. Hands off Paterka. Back to Doyle. And a foul. And that's on Withers. That's his 5th. And what a disappointing semifinal for an All-American. Todd Withers fouls out with just 1 point on the night.
In 31 minutes.
He only took 4 shots. He was like 0 of 4. And they were all from 3. Off the miss, Agassi grabs it.
Tried to tip it out.
Agassi moving closer to a career high. He's got 17. His career best is 20. Here's Willett with the 4 fouls. Carr traveled. Turnover number 14 for the Royals. And that's their average, 14 per game. Knocked away. And Smith recovers. Smith, jumper. It's good. It's amazing how quiet this place gets when they're on offense, and then they explode when the Wolves are on defense. The lead is 4. Agassi reverse, and he draws the foul.
But Deion Kulu didn't even come out on Smith that time on that three-point shot.
And Doyle just picked up his 4th.
Did he foul?
And Evans at the scores table. Looks like Doyle will come out.
I mean, Agassi goes in there looking for contact, but he's tried it 3 times, and they've called it twice. I don't know if that was a foul.
2 out of 2 for Agassi. 79-77, 3:20 to go in OT.
Here comes the big pressure.
They break it. Numbers. The lob to Dennis Evans.
Picture perfect press breaker.
Davis cans the triple.
What a big shot. What a game.
81-80. 2:45 to go. Again, you can hear it happen here right now with the Wolves on offense. Smith through the paint. Smith gets it to go.
He's very crafty. He'll use the screen, not use the screen.
Wolves are 4 for 4 in overtime. Willett fouled. That's been Queens' offense.
This is a picture-perfect press break. Pollard to Carter Evans.
And now Evans has 4 fouls. So Paul Sather's just kind of looked up. Well, what do I do now? Like, both my big guys have 4 fouls.
Keep playing. If you go out, next one comes in. This is not time to let somebody score and worry about fouling out. If a guy's got a layup, you got to use that 5th foul at this point in the game.
Paterka trying to get it in. Bounces it to Pollard. Guarded by Davis. Pollard carefully brings it up, and now over to Paterka.
They switched up.
Evans draws the double, and he's fouled. Good call. Fourth foul on Jalen Alexander. And now Evans at the line. 56% free throw shooter. The senior from Rochester, Minnesota.
That didn't look good.
Nail biter all around here in Sioux Falls. Missed them both. And tipped out to Davis. Still a 2-point Northern State lead. Shot clock at 8. Agassi launches. And hits the 3. The Royals up 1. And Bart Lundy calls timeout. Foul trouble for both teams. Paterka, Evans, Doyle, 4 each for the Wolves. For Queens, Withers is fouled out. Alexander, Willett have 4 apiece.
Let's see if they run and jump them. Just a straight man pressure.
8 ties, 11 lead changes tonight. Smith poked away by Willett. And what a great play by Carr to save it.
Just solid defense. Got plenty of time. You're only down one.
Willett has had a nice game for Queens, the junior out of Palm Bay, Florida.
Yes, he has.
Final minute of overtime. Agassi around King. Shot clock at two. They got to put one up. Agassi drills it.
What a big three. They're going to look at it. Possibly get something going to the basket. Score, timeout.
Northern State has two timeouts remaining. They need a bucket. Smith, jumper, no good. Rebound, Davis. But a foul called on Queens inside. Daniel Carr called for the foul, going for the rebound.
Wow.
That's a big call.
Huge.
Underneath. You saw Doyle go to the ground. And Doyle now will go to the line. And stops the clock. 28.9 to go. Doyle makes the first. Now the shot clock's turned off. So the Wolves obviously have to foul.
Have to foul.
Remember the end of regulation, 6 second difference. They elected not to foul, but in this case, different story.
No choice.
Doyle, one out of two. And there's the foul committed by Pollard. It'll be Jalen Alexander going to the free throw line. Alexander tonight, one out of two at the line. And he's 75% on the season. Both teams in the double bonus. Two free throws for the senior Alexander out of Newberry, South Carolina.
Got to get something quick here, that's all. I call timeout. But they cannot walk the ball off the floor.
Big free throws for Alexander. Checking into the game. Makes them both. Queens has scored on six consecutive trips. And it's a five-point game with 27 seconds left.
You need to go hard to the basket.
Shooting a three. Bart Lundy can't believe it as Dion Kulu gives the Wolves a gift.
I mean, clearly a foul. I'm just surprised that they went for the three right away. Yeah, he's behind the line. Hit him with the body, actually.
So three free throws for Pollard. 84% free throw shooter. Senior out of St. Louis Park, Minnesota.
I'm just surprised they take Dion Kulu out on offense all the time. He's been so good this whole game.
Not a good free throw shooter, though. Just 57%.
There you go.
Whoa, he missed it. Rebound! Pollard, three, got it! Agassi, Willett, Alexander, and Carr.
I think it's going to be on Pollard to stop this kid.
Agassi, a career night. Can he add to it? 5 seconds to go. Agassi with three. Agassi drives. Blocked by Pollard. And that shot is no good. And we're going to double overtime in Sioux Falls. Years ago, Augusta in Central Oklahoma. And we are tied at 89, not done. With Steve Lapis, Jamie Erno, our entire crew, I'm Andrew Catalan. What a game this has been with a spot in the national championship game on the line.
Boy, these kids are leaving it all. What a pass.
And then the dump off to Evans.
Boy, these kids are leaving it all out here. They know this is a chance of a lifetime.
Good fake. Alexander can't hit the three. And tipped out to Agassi. A fresh shot clock for the Royals. And the pass out of bounds. It's Northern State basketball.
Okay, so no harm, no foul.
And they're staying with the call. But
there was indisputable evidence that shouldn't have been looked at.
Shouldn't have been able to have it.
All right. Sixth turnover by Agassi right there. Wide open Pollard three. Yes!
How about this guy?
15 for Pollard. Davis trying to answer. He can't. And the rebound to Evans.
Bad shot. Too quick.
Pollard did not score in the first half. He's got 15 after halftime. The lead is 5. Smith reverses. No good. The tip is good for Evans. Bart Lundy's got to get a timeout.
Needing the timeout right now.
Oh, he changes his mind. He was calling for Agassi to come over. It's a 12-0 run. Willett drives. No good. Rebound to Evans, and Paterka will slow it down.
Yeah, not calling timeout. There was...
Paterka, nice feed. Evans drives in. No good. And taken off the glass by Davis. Up ahead, Willett. Willett. Sends it back out. Davis three. And Paterka grabs it. With less than 3 minutes to go in double overtime.
I think Northern State still has to keep being aggressive on offense.
Ten on the shot clock. Smith driving at Deion Kulu. Smith wins that battle. 14 straight points for Northern State. And now Lundy wants a timeout. This place is up for grabs.
Been able to do that is in the final 2 minutes of regulation. He believes they might have realized that, which is why the call remained the same as they've left the table.
All right, Jamie, thanks for clarifying. That's exactly what we said.
And it did look like it was all Northern State.
Alexander hits the three, and that stops the 14-0 run. But it's still a six-point game with 2 minutes to go. Paterka struggling to get it in, and a foul. And that's going to go on Carr. What a turnaround. Queens was up 5 with 20 seconds to go in the first overtime. Now they're down 6 late in the second OT.
That's why you got to put them away when you have the chance, because you never know.
How about Ian Smith at the line? He's played 48 minutes tonight. 20 points, 7 assists. 21 points now. Have hit triple digits. Agassi. Jumper. Yes.
He's been so tough this whole game. Getting in the lane. They have not been able to guard him.
He's got 27. Paterka gets it in. And Pollard brings it across. And a foul. With 90 seconds to go.
They certainly didn't need to foul there. I don't think they wanted to foul there.
Foul number four on Mike Davis. Pollard, an 84% free throw shooter. If you're just tuning in, Northern State, located in Aberdeen, South Dakota, 200 miles away, about a three-hour drive. And this crowd is about 98% Northern State fans.
How about this kid Pollard tonight?
17 all after halftime for Pollard. And the shot won't go for Alexander.
You got a foul. You definitely need to foul. You're down eight. Well, if you're not going to foul now,
yeah, might as well wait.
Oh, Harris, he got a hand on it.
Paterka retreats. Now you don't want to foul.
No.
Shot clock at 10. Hey. Doyle missed it. Put back. Yes. That's a backbreaker for the Royals. Carr in the paint. Who wants to take a shot? Davis will. And the rebound comes out to Carr. Carr goes right back in. Missed it. Dioncoulou to put back. Yes. And Bart Lundy calls timeout. That's the last timeout for the Royals with 33 seconds to.
They got to try for the 5 second and then foul immediately.
Paterka in the corner. He has to call timeout. Northern State has one remaining with 30 seconds to go.
And now they get.
That's deep pass. Broken up by Agassi. Paterka comes in and goes out of bounds. And they haven't made a call. Now they're going to say Wolves basketball. Now. 26.7 to go in double overtime. An 8-point Northern State lead. They get it in. They nearly turn it over. Now a tie-up. And the possession arrow favors Queens. With 24 seconds to go, the Royals get it back.
Well, obviously they can use a three here, but they just, whatever they do, they got to score. And it's got time. It's got to be quick.
Dioncoulou comes back in, and Willett goes out.
That helps. They threw right into the backcourt.
Agassi, 4 of 8 from deep. Attempting another. Short. Rebound Davis. Passes to Dioncoulou. Now the triple for Alexander. Won't go. Doyle, the rebound. 10 seconds to go, and he's fouled. This has been some game.
Tremendous
some game.
Game.
Well played on both sides with a great atmosphere, terrific environment for the D2 semifinals. And Northern State on the verge of advancing to the title game for the first time in program history. What's this place going to feel like for the championship game on Saturday?
Wow.
This is close to a three-hour basketball game.
It's a good thing we're off tomorrow.
Agassi for three. No good. Tipped around. And there is Carr's three. Is good. They inbound. That will do it. The Wolves are going to the title game.